This is the story of the 4,000-year-old Aboriginal rock art of the Wandjinas, the sky beings. Hi everyone, what's up? I am GH aka DOZgeek. It's good to be back here with you on Section 51 on YouTube. Thank you for your support to the channel as always. It's still the time to subscribe to our private space if you want to have access to more confidential stuff or some hot stuff. The following Aboriginal rock art was originally carved 4,000 years ago, and as you can tell, right off the bat, it appears to be showcasing some sort of weird alien ghost beings, unlike anything we have ever seen before. Luckily, we do have some context to back it all up, as according to the original carvers of this rock art, the Australian Aboriginal people consider these to be the Wandjinas, aka the supreme spiritual beings that ruled over our planet 60,000 years ago and effectively created us in the meantime. Australian Aboriginal people claim they originally came to our planet 60,000 years ago from an unknown place, and they took over the lands here, which they renamed as the land of the Wandjina. The whole territory spanned for around 200,000 square miles, and they reigned over the Aboriginals at the time, and peace ensued as no one was there to inflict any conflicts. Their lands also covered the islands from the northwestern side of Australia, and they are believed to be the first civilization to have ever sailed over such a massive patch of land. This tribal rock art supposedly portrays the three Wandjina tribes, aka the Warora, the Ngarinyin, and the Wunumbul. They all appear to have no mouth, a halo around their head, which is most likely an astronaut helmet, white faces, which may again be attributed to the astronaut suit, and massive black eyes. Many believe that they were actually ghosts all along because of their dark eyes and their white faces, but the general consensus is that they were actually extraterrestrial beings that ruled over us thousands of years ago. The Wandjina created the landscape and its inhabitants, and continue to have influence over both. When the spirits found the place they would die, they painted their images on cave walls and entered a nearby waterhole. These paintings were then refreshed by Aboriginal people as a method of regenerating life force. The Wandjina can punish those who break the law with floods, lightning, and cyclones. The Wandjina and Wungur spirits are essential elements of the life. Wungur is a variant on the rainbow serpent creator being belief, while the Wandjina are local spirits, attached to places and associated with particular clans. Although some local expressions use the two terms interchangeably, Wungur is a more diffuse life force animating and underlying the particular manifestations of its power that find expression in all species of things, including the Wandjina. One facet of Wungur is embodied in a rock python known as Wanjad. Indigenous people of the Mowanjum community repaint the images to ensure the continuity of the Wandjina's presence. Annual repainting in December or January also ensures the arrival of the monsoon rains, according to Mo Wanjun belief. Many raise logical questions, such as why were the Wandjinas painted with white skin if it was representing another Aboriginal, all of whom had black skin? Why were the eyes always painted so disproportionate to the face and nose? And why were they all painted without a mouth? But what is even more surprising is the oral account of the Wandjinas, which has been passed from generation to generation, as all of the Aboriginal Dreamtime stories have. The story goes like this. The Wandjina were sky beings or spirits from the clouds who came down from the Milky Way during Dreamtime and created the Earth and all its inhabitants. Then Wandjina looked upon the inhabitants and realized the enormity of the task and returned home to bring more Wandjinas. With the aid of the Dreamtime snake, the Wandjina descended and spent their Dreamtime creating, teaching and being gods to the Aboriginals whom they created. After some time, the Wandjinas disappeared. They descended into the earth and since then have lived at the bottom of the water source associated with each of the paintings. There, they continually produce new child seeds which are regarded as the source of all human life. Some Wandjina also returned to the sky and can now be seen at night as lights moving high above the earth. Aboriginal people in the Kimberley also believe that even after they disappeared, the Wandjina continued to control everything that happened on the land and in the sky and sea. Aboriginal Dreamtime stories, rock art and cave paintings have often been considered more myth than reality, like the stories we find in the teachings of modern-day religions. However, recent archaeological discoveries have confirmed the reality of at least some of the Dreamtime stories. For example, those that spoke of huge man-moles walking the earth were once considered fantasy. But discoveries of animal fossils belonging to megafauna, including giant man-moles, confirmed that these stories were accounts of real-life events passed down by generations over tens of thousands of years. Interestingly, and of course controversially, objects have been found on geographical sites which suggest the area had been inhabited as long as 174,000 before Christ. This contradicts the theory that Aboriginals had their roots in Africa and that inhabitants traveled from Africa to Australia about 60,000 years ago. Other researchers have suggested that Homo sapiens actually originated in Australia. Today, the Aboriginal tribes of the Woiwurra, the Ngarrindjin and Wunnambool still revere the Wandjina and only certain individuals are given permission to paint them. It is said that the Wandjina could punish those who broke the law with floods, lightning and cyclones, and the paintings of the Wandjina are believed to possess these powers. Therefore, according to the Aboriginals, they are always to be approached and treated respectfully. Why would ancient Aboriginal people create so-called myths or fanciful stories if it meant so much to them and remains so important to their culture to this day? So many myths and legends of the past have already been proven true by archaeological findings, such as the legend of the city of Troy, the labyrinth of the Minotaur, Norse legends of navigational crystals, and many more. Could it not be that the Aboriginal people of the time were simply telling of events as they saw them and how they understood them at the time? Can we link the Wandjina with the ancient alien theory? Perhaps one day we will uncover the answers to these intriguing questions. And you, what do you think of all this? Were the Wandjina alien gods? Do they really exist? What alien race could they be related? Are they still watching us? I hope you enjoyed this video, and while waiting for the next video, as usual, you can find us on social networks like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. And please like, share, subscribe, support Section 51. I'll be back really soon. Open your eyes, watch the sky, live long and prosper.